When you are on the receiving end of abuse from a toxic person, it can be hard to not take it personally. Today, I will discuss why you shouldn't take their abuse personally, even if it feels very personal. As I discuss this topic, it can apply to any type of relationship and not only a dating relationship. This can be with your boss, coworker, friend, sibling, or parent. The type of relationship might make the abuse feel more personal. However, the abuse from the person is still abuse, regardless of how you know them. If the abuse from them isn't personal, how do you not take their abuse personally? But first, I'm Dr. Emily Mayfield, a licensed psychologist. Thank you for watching this video and being a part of the Mindset Therapy family. Let me start with why abuse from a toxic person feels personal. The most straightforward reason why it feels personal is because they make it personal. Abusers are watchers and they know what buttons to push with the people they abuse. However, you may not notice they're watching everything you do because they hide it well. When you try to live with them or interact with them, they may appear distant and disinterested in you. You tell them about your day and what your interests are and they ignore you. Abusers are rarely supportive, and to share a story with them is a chance for them to exert control over you and make you feel unwanted. Yes, this is part of their abusive strategy. The abuser wants you to feel unimportant and invalidate your experiences because when they see you hurt, it makes them feel better about themselves. They appear to not be interested in what you have to say because that is one way they can abuse you. However, the abusive person, to include narcissists, is actually listening to you, even if they pretend they aren't. To be fully effective in their abusive strategies, they need to know what hurts you the most and what buttons to push. When you discuss positive things in your life or even negative interactions and situations, they are actively listening. All this information can later be used against you in their attacks on you. When the abuser belittles you, name calls, or otherwise puts you down, they use the very topics you have already discussed as important to you. Did you tell them the other day how excited you are about making a new friend and having dinner with them? This innocent story later becomes content for their abuse by them telling you the new friend doesn't really like you and they only went out with you because they feel sorry for you. Or did you express sadness with the job loss you experienced? Again, they will twist this to be about you and what is wrong with you. They will remind you that you can't do anything right, and if you were smarter, better looking, or more friendly, then maybe you could have kept the job. And these abusive statements from them don't come in the moment. They come later. If they can bring up the abusive statements later, their words are much more powerful. You thought they didn't care to begin with about what you had to say, so you just assumed they weren't listening to you. But they were actively listening so they can later use your own experiences against you later. This is why the abuse from the narcissist and other abusive people feels personal. They know exactly what to say to make you feel bad about yourself. Even if you didn't think those negative things about yourself before, you at least consider it as possibly true because why else would they say it? So, if the narcissist or other abusive person makes it personal, how do you not take it personally? They have attacked you at your core, so surely they mean what they say. First and foremost, you must remind yourself that the abuser is abusive. You likely know they are abusive and choose to overlook it at times. However, you must default to placing the blame on them and not on yourself. When people abuse, they are blame shifting and making their victim feel as if they are the problem. The fastest way to make someone feel like they are the problem is to make them the problem. And there is no better way to do that than to attack who they are as a person. When you feel attacked, you go on the defensive and try to explain how what they are saying is wrong. Now the focus is on you and your alleged fault, and this is exactly where the abuser wants your focus to be. If you have an abuser in your life who attacks with their words, don't take the bait. They want you to respond to their words because your reaction inflates their fragile ego. Don't give them that satisfaction by taking the bait. This can be very difficult in the moment and will take practice. The best thing you can do is prepare yourself for interactions with that person whenever possible. Before going into the interaction, remind yourself of their abusive ways and desire to put you down to feel better about themselves. This will help you feel less off guard when they become abusive. Of course, not all verbal attacks are something you can prepare for. For situations in which you are truly caught off guard, you want to practice stepping away when they say something abusive to you. This will be hard and require practice. However, start to work on not feeling the need to defend yourself or otherwise comment on their abusive words. Remind yourself that they aren't attacking you personally and they are only using words to make you feel worse about yourself because they know that will get a reaction from you. If the words weren't targeted at you, you wouldn't take the bait and their abuse would be less effective. So while it feels personal, it isn't about you. It is about them and their own insecurities. Abusive people don't know how to make themselves feel better on their own, so they abuse others as a way to boost their self-esteem. To learn more about baiting done by the narcissist and how to not take the bait, click on the video in the corner, or you can find the link in the description below. See you at the next video.